May I have your attention, please? I have everyone's attention. Anyone who haven't had a chance to view, we're going to ask you to please come now and view. Your first service will be starting very shortly. If you haven't had a chance to view, please come up now. Thank you.
We have gathered here today to praise God and to witness to our faith as we celebrate the life of Keith G. Dunkley. Dying, Christ destroyed our death. Rising, Christ restored our life. As in baptism, Keith put on Christ, so now in Christ, may Keith be clothed with glory. Here and now, we are God's children. Come together in grief, acknowledging our human loss. May God grant us grace that in pain we may find comfort, in sorrow, hope, in death, and resurrection. Give to us now your grace, that as we shrink before the mystery of death, we may see the light of eternity. Speak to us once more your solemn message of life and death. Help us to live as those who are prepared to die, and when our days here are accomplished, enable us to die as those who go forth to live, so that or dying, our life may be in you. And nothing in life or in death able to separate us from your love. Jesus said, I am the resurrection and I am the life. Those who believe in me, even though they die, yet shall they live. And whoever lives and believes in me shall never die. I am the Alpha and Omega, the beginning and end, the first and the last. I died, and behold, I am alive evermore. I hold peace to the kingdom. As I live, I shall live also. Let us pray. Eternal God, we praise you, great company of all. Today, we especially praise you for Keith, whom you have graciously received into your presence. To all of these, grant your peace. Let your light shine upon them, and help us so to believe where we have not seen, that your presence may lead us through our years and bring us at last with them into the joy of your home, not made with hands, but eternal in the heavens. Through Jesus Christ we pray. Amen. And now please stand as you are able to sing hymn number 378, Amazing Grace.
Thank you.
please join me in reading responsively Psalm 23. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He leads me beside still waters. He restores my soul. Even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, thou preparest a table before me in the presence of my enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil. My cup overflows. Seated. Loving God, you have been our dwelling place in all generations. You are a refuge and a strength, a very present help in times of trouble. Bring to us your love this hour and allow our trust in you that our spirits may grow calm and our hearts be comforted. Lift our eyes beyond the shadow. Help us to see the light that we may find grace and strength in our time. Now let us join together to sing hymn number 504.
Thank you.
I would invite Owen Dunkley forward to read our psalm for this morning.
Wow. Good morning, church. Oh, what a day the Lord has made us. I will rejoice and be blessed. Oh, gosh, this is my brother laying there. Oh, what a day. This is Psalms 37. Ladies and gentlemen, fret not thyself because of evil doers. Neither thou envious against the works of iniquity. For they shall soon be cut down like the grass and wither as the green herb. Trust in the Lord and be good. So shall thou dwell in the land, and verily shall be fed. Delight thyself also in the Lord, and he shall give thee desire of thy heart. Ladies and gentlemen, again, it's a day. I'm going to miss my brother. I just want to speak on behalf of my
good morning, everyone. Keith G. Dunkley was born in Montego Bay, St. James, Jamaica, to Cordell Daisy and Daniel Dunkley on December 11th, 1938. And he passed away on April 1st, 2024. He was one of six brothers and one sister. He was a good husband to Beryl Dunkley, his wife of 64 years, whom he lovingly called B. He was the father of five children, 13 grandchildren, and 15 great-grandchildren. Keith started working at a young age of 14 years old at hotels in St. James, Jamaica, before he joined the staff at Aramark Hotel in St. Anne's, Jamaica. He worked for over 23 years in hospitality business before migrating to the USA 50 years ago. Shortly after arriving in Albany, New York, he worked at a beverage center on Warren Street for many years, and then at the State Office Building cafeteria at 44 Holland Avenue. He was later employed by the cafeteria at the New York State Teachers Retirement Building, 10 Corporate Woods, and later at the Meals on Wheels at Rensselaer Street, after which he retired. He was preceded in death by his dad, Daniel, Mother Cordell, granddaughter Princess, Sister Carmen, brothers Desmond, Keith, and Ransford, sister-in-law Stella, brother-in-law Robert, and his grandson Rossi, my brother, and his wife Beryl. He is survived by sons Michael, Denton, Maxine, O'Neill, Regina, and daughters Marcia, Clifton, and Beasia, Kurt, along with 11 grandchildren, 15 great-grandchildren, many nieces and nephews, sister-in-law Cherry in the UK, and brothers Lascelle, Angela, and Owen Ellen, as well as extended family. He had a life, a full life, and many tales of childhood with his mom and his five brothers and sisters, visiting and staying with his grandfather in the country. For the summers, leaving school early to work, traveling late at night from St. Anne to Montego Bay to get home so he could be there when his children were awoke. His tales included his adventures through the back roads in his van haul to visit his wife's family in the D-side. Fun times with his wife and children on his days off or on his vacation. Road trips up and down the Jamaican North Coast from St. Anne to Mo Bay for visits. The family moved to St. Anne for a short 5 years, but he brought them back to his family back home in Montego Bay before migrating to the U.S. His family grew, and he loved being a grandpa and spending time with his grandchildren and great-grandchildren. When they were little, he would take them to get pizza, picnics in the backyard, birthday parties, family dinners. Keith loves his family, and he will be greatly missed. Thank y'all.
Please stand as you are able to sing hymn number 2147, which is found in the Faith We Sing, His Eye is on the Sparrow.
Thank you.
Please be seated. I would invite Matthew Fells up to read the gospel this morning.
Good morning. Reading from the book of Matthew, chapter 5, verses 1 through 12. And seeing the multitudes, he went up into a mountain, and when he was set, his disciples came unto him. And he opened his mouth and taught them, saying, Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are they that mourn, for they shall be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they shall inherit the earth. Blessed are they which do hunger and thirst after righteousness, for they shall be filled. Blessed are the merciful, for they shall obtain mercy. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see God. Blessed are they which are persecuted for righteousness' sake, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are ye when men shall revile you and persecute you, and shall say all manner of evil against you falsely for my sake. Rejoice and be exceeding glad, for great is your reward in heaven. For so persecuted they the prophets which were before you.
I think Keith touched all of our lives, everyone who is gathered here in many ways. And now I'd ask that those of you who would like to share your remembrances of Keith, that we enter this a period of sharing, that we remember, that we celebrate his life, his smile. That always struck me when he came into the office to visit, his smile and his care for everyone. So anyone who would like to come forward and share your memories.
Giving all glory and honor to God, who is the author and finisher of my life, and to acknowledge the leader of this house, to the family and friends, in the name of Jesus Christ, I greet you. Good morning. This is the day that the Lord has made, and we will rejoice and be glad in it. I had the privilege and the honor to meet Keith back in 1979, affectionately known as the General. And you cannot mention Keith without mentioning B. Beryl. Keith demonstrated God's love. God calls for us to love one another as he loved us. And I was blessed to be loved by Keith as he demonstrated God's love in my life. Blessed to have had such an awesome grandfather. And Keith was never embarrassed. He always would share the gospel with me. And not only that, when we talked on the phone, he would always ask me how I was doing. And he never forgot to say how much he loved me. He was a man who According to the Bible, it says when a man finds a wife, he finds a good thing. And Keith understood the scriptures and demonstrated that he understood God's word by being married for 64 years. That is longer than a lifetime. So as we celebrate his life, he will always have fond memories in my heart. I am always grateful. It was up until the last 2 years, I would come home from church and they would call me and Keith would say, come by, we've got food for you. Ever since I met him, he has always looked out for me. There was nothing that he wouldn't do for me and Nikhila. And I really felt God's presence. And I'm grateful and I will always be thankful. And I'd like to publicly acknowledge Marcia, because ever since I've met you, you have been quite a model. And you have been a great daughter. And, you know, God honors all that is seen, and he also honors all that is unseen. And so I just want you to know that everything you've done does not go unnoticed, because he saw it all. You've been a great daughter. And thank you.
God grant me serenity to accept the things I cannot change, courage to change the things I can, and the wisdom to know the difference. Mr. Keith Dunkley was a great friend of mine. We belonged to the same fellowship for many years. Mr. Dunkley was a person that anyone would like to have in their fellowship. He lived a good life, and we get to know each other for many years. I want to give condolence to his family. He have many children, many grandchildren, like myself. We drink from the same cups for many years. And we stop drinking from the same cup for many years, and we live a good life. It's a pleasure to be here with this family today. I haven't seen Owen in so many years. I had to ask a Rastafari, the Most High, to point out my little brother to me. So it's good to be here. And I know Mr. Dunkley is in a good place. He's in his father's home. Thank you.
Just briefly, my name is Richard Moneymaker. I worked with Keith as an usher in this church for many years. Keith was an excellent usher. He took the job very seriously, had a lot of dignity about himself. Whether we were passing out bulletins, ushering people up to the church for communion, we're collecting offerings. Keith made sure everything went smoothly. He was very serious about it, and everything always did. I also marveled at the fact that Keith was also very welcoming. He had a good, clean, good comment to make to everybody as they came in the church, and that was a blessing. Keith was a blessing, and we will definitely miss him. Thank you.
I'm Nancy Law. I'm a member here at Trinity, too. And I want to echo what Richard said, that Keith was a fixture here, and he welcomed everyone so warmly. And he was like a second grandfather to my kids, because he will always tell them to sit up straight, respect their mother, and he always checked their, you know, clothes to make sure they were appropriate, and he always gave them little peppermints every Sunday, and they look forward to seeing him, and he watched them grow up, and he was so proud of all of his family, shared all of his stories with us, and his life in Jamaica, and his, he was so proud of all of you, and we're going to miss him.
We give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good.
Oops.
For his mercy is endured forever. My condolence to the Dunkley family. Your family has been intertwined with my family for many, many years. I've known the Dunkley family since I was about like 9. I remember Miss Beryl coming to St. Elizabeth. I remember Annette. She came with her mom when I was a little girl. But I, from time to time, I call. I would check on Mr. Dunkley. He always has something good to say. And I just want to let you know that Psalms 121 says, I will lift up mine eyes to the hills. From whence cometh my help? And just know that your help cometh from the Lord, which make heaven and earth. He will not suffer your foot to be moved, and he that keepeth you will not slumber. Behold, he that keepeth Israel shall neither slumber nor sleep. The Lord is thy keeper. The Lord is thy shade upon thy right hand. The sun shall not smite thee by day, nor the moon by night. The Lord shall preserve thee from all evil. He shall preserve thy soul. The Lord shall preserve thy going out and thy coming in from this time forth and even forevermore. God bless.
Thank you.
Good afternoon. I'm Deshaun. I am Sade's husband, father of the twins, and Nina. Hi, baby. I wanted to come here and give my respects to the family and to tell them how grateful I am to be a part. And if you know anything about the Fowles, the men in the family are quiet. It's that quiet strength. But Mr. Dunkley was always the talkative one. And he was always, for a person who's new to the family, he's like the perfect person to connect with. And I miss that from him. His daughter takes after him with the stories and the love and the food and the respect. And I felt that. And I wanted to extend that and let you guys know that I felt that and I feel that every time I'm around you guys. And I see him in you guys. And I'm listening to your stories and hearing you guys tell your experiences and share your love. And sometimes, you know, the shade for each other. Same thing in my family. It's real. But I respect your honesty. I respect your love. And he's a reflection. You are a reflection of him. He is here with you. He will be here with you always and forever. I lost my grandmother 2 days after the twins were born, and it was tough. And so I completely understand where you guys are and how you guys feel. And I really, truly, from the Moore family, want to extend my gratitude. Brother Dunkley was just energetic and loving and respectful. And he also didn't overstay his welcome. He was like, I'm going to be here, y'all going to see me, and I'm out. And I respect that because everybody's time is precious, and he respected that. And I know he loved you guys. And so I'm just here on behalf of the Moors. My family couldn't make it, but they send their... Oh, hey, they made it. All right. So our family is blended. If you guys need anybody to talk to, hug on, I'm here. But I wanted to extend my warmest appreciation and respect for your father. He is loved and he will be missed. Thank you.
Good morning, good afternoon again. I'm Matthew, his grandson. I'm going to remember and miss him. I remember all the Saturday mornings when Shadi and I were growing up, and he would show up, you know, 8 in the morning, 9 in the morning, when everybody's still asleep, waking us up and spending time with us. I'm going to remember him taking me out for pizza Saturday mornings and bringing me to the bank. I didn't know why he was bringing me to the bank. He'd deposit a little bit of money, and then when I graduated high school, he gave me a check all the time that he went to the bank on Saturday mornings. He was putting in a couple dollars for me. So I'll never forget when he did that. I'm going to miss the bickering between him and Grandma every time we saw them. But I know it was out of love. I'm gonna miss the calls from Grandma and Grandpa. I'm gonna miss them. Like Deshaun said, I'm not a man of many words, and I never know what to say when I call my grandparents, which is why I don't call as often, but they knew that I loved them. And I'm going to miss them, and I love all of you as well. Thank you.
And so Keith touched our lives in so many ways, either directly or indirectly, all with God's love. And although it is his death that has brought us here, and it seems to be our pain and our grief that are the main emotions that we're feeling, in actuality, it is what he did, it is how he lived that really bring us here today. The way he seemed to know how to touch people's lives. It is the love that we all felt in his presence. For without that love, we would not be feeling this pain and this loss. We would not be here grieving and mourning. And so we're here today to celebrate and to give thanks for his life, for the fact that we had the honor of having our lives intersect with his. We celebrate the joy that he gave to others, that smile. Keith would often visit the church office. He came 2 or 3 times a month in the last 2.5 years that I've been serving here. 2 or 3 times a month, I got to see his smile, his joy. And I think I know why he was a greeter and an usher here at Trinity for so long, because just that smile alone was a welcoming presence. He always laughed and never, ever complained. There was so much joy. He also cared for all of us. He gave of himself. He was so giving. Every single time he came to the office, he would bring a gift, a book that he thought I might enjoy, a stuffed cat for my daughter, a blanket for my son, little things, so giving. And we celebrate his love. He always spoke of the love that he had for his children, how much he missed his wife, and the love that he had for his church family. His generosity and his faith in God should be an example to all of us. And so with that example that he set for the rest of us, it is no wonder that this is a time for us to mourn, but also a time to celebrate. And as part of that celebration, it is also a time that we give thanks to God that he was a part of our lives. And I think he will always remain a part of our lives. Let us pray. God of us all, your love never ends. We pray to you and for one another, and for everyone, anywhere who mourns with us today. To those who doubt, give light. To those who are weak, strength. To all who sorrow your peace, keep true in us the love which we hold for one another. O God, all that you have given us is yours. As at first you gave Keith to us, we now give Keith back to you. Receive Keith into the arms of your mercy. Raise Keith up with all your people. Receive us also and raise us into a new life. Help us to love and serve you in this world, that we may enter into your joy in the world to come. Amen. Let us pray. God of love, we thank you for all that you have given us, even to this day, for the gift of joy in days of health and strength, and for the gifts of your abiding presence and promise in the days of pain and grief. We give you praise for home and friends, and a place in your church with all who have faithfully lived and died. Above all else, we give you thanks for the life of Jesus, who knew our griefs and who lives and prays with us. As he taught us to pray, so now we pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. And now please stand as you are able to sing hymn number 474, Precious Lord, Take My Hand.
Thank you.
The peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and God's Son, Jesus. And the blessing of God Almighty, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, be among you and remain with you always. Amen.
Everyone, let's go into the cemetery. We're going to ask when you procession out of the church that you please go directly to your cars, turn your headlights on and your four-way flashes, and we'll be ready to procession. We have a time limit that we're supposed to be at the cemetery, so please go directly to your cars. Pallbearers, will you please come forward, those of you who are pallbearers.